So how do we convert numbers from decimal to binary? So if I have a number like 45 in decimal, how do I convert that to binary? Well, there is a way of doing it you might like, you might prefer, and so you might not. We can say, how many times does 2 go into 45? Okay, it 2 goes into 45 how many times? Well, it's going to go in there 22 times. Okay, and what about the remainder? Well, out to the side, we write the remainder. In this case, 2 times 22 is 44, which leaves us with a remainder of 1 when we do that division. Okay, how many times does 2 go into 22? It's going to go in there 11 times. With a remainder of what? Well, in that case, it's a remainder of 0. Okay? How many times does 2 go into 11? It goes in 5 times. With a remainder of what? Well, it's going to go in with a remainder of 1. 2 times 5 is 10. We need one more to get to 11, so there's a remainder of 1. 2 goes into 5 how many times? Well, 2 goes into 5 2 times with a remainder of 1. 2 goes into 2 how many times? 1 with a remainder of 0. 2 goes into 1 how many times? And as soon as we get to 0, we're done. 0 with a remainder of what? 1. Then we start from the top and write down, and we get 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1 is our answer. Okay, so that's one way of doing it. Again, this is our answer. The remainders is our answer. We start from the top and work our way down to the bottom, writing the numbers left to right. So 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, and that should be equivalent. Now, I'll do that if I get a number that's pretty complicated. But for me, I kind of prefer the process of reversing what we did before and just writing out the number of digits. And if I need more, I'll get more. But I say, this is the ones place, this is the twos place, this is the fours place. Again, we're in binary. So eights place, 16s place, 32. And we don't need any more than the number because it'll just be zeros after that. So 32 is the biggest because the next one's 64, so we don't need this one. Which switches, this is the way I think of it to myself, and this is just Spencer's way of doing it. Which switches do I need to flip on in order to make a 45? I know I can get a 32 in there, but if I try and add a 16 to a 32, that's going to give me a 48, and that's going to be too much. So that's got to be a 0. But I can get an 8 in there, which will take me to 40, so I'll turn that one on. I can get a 4 in there, which will take me to 44. Then I won't be able to get a 2, but I will be able to get a 1. And we get the same exact number doing it through that process, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. Okay, so you can choose which of those two ways you prefer doing it, and sometimes it just depends on the number. So if I get a number, let's do another one. Let's say I get a number like just a little bit bigger. Let's do like a 139 in decimal. What is that in binary? Okay, so we can go through I'll go through both processes again. I'll have to write a little smaller. I keep wanting this to scroll when I do this, but I'm using this little pen. It does not scroll. 139. 2 goes into 139 how many times? Well, it's going to go in there one less than 70, so it'll be 69 with a remainder of 1. 2 goes into 69 how many times? Well, it's going to go in there one less than 35, right? And so 34 with a remainder of 1. 2 goes into 34 how many times? 17 with a remainder of 0. 2 goes into 17 how many times? It'll be 8 with a remainder of 1. 2 goes into 8 how many times? 4 with a remainder of 0. 2 goes into 4 how many times? 2 with a remainder of 0. 2 goes into 2 how many times? 1 with a remainder of 0. 2 goes into 1 how many times? 0 with a remainder of 1. And so a 139 is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay, trying it the other way. So I have 1s, 2s, 4s, 8s, 16, 32, 64. Do I need another one? Yeah, I do, because I can still go 128. The one after that would be 256. So we're not going to ever get to 256. Okay, I need a 128. I can fit one in there, but as soon as I try and do a 64, that'll push me over 139. So I can't do that. That's going to be a 0. That's off. A 32 would also push me over. That's off. Okay, how about a 128 plus a 16? Well, that's going to take me to 144, right? So that's over. That's off. How about an 8, which is horribly written? You can't even tell it's an 8 anymore. Yeah, I can get an 8 in there. 128 plus 8 takes me to 136, so yes. Okay. And I have 3 left. I could just know I'm going to do a 2 and a 1, put that as a 0, and that should end up as the same number, which it did. Okay, so you can pick whichever method you like, but that's how we convert from a binary number to a decimal number. Or sorry, the other way around, a decimal number to a binary number. Let's try converting from a decimal number to a hex number and see what happens in the next video. Spencer out.